Hello hockey fans. In today's segment of Keeping Up with the Tkachuks, we will be unpacking the latest drama unfolding in the National Hockey League. As of late, there has been a shitload of talk around questionable goaltender interference penalties and complaints that the league is starting to treat goalies like Tom Brady, aka you can't touch them or even look at them without getting shafted by your stick blade. The most recent incident occurred last night during Florida's shitty attempt to desperately save their bloody horrific start of a season by getting a win. It was supposed to be easy, seeing as all they had to do was defeat a team full of Hollywood actors who like to suck off the refs, also known as the LA Kings. Both teams have their daddy issues, but there was one player in this game who seemed completely unable to get his panties out of a wad. Can you guess who it was? Yes, you guessed it. Matthew Tkachuk, aka the monkey-looking dude who chews his slobbery mouthguard like a newborn baby attached to its mom, except everybody hates his guts. This guy is usually always scummy, but he turned into an evil menace after a series of events unfolded. Let me take you along the journey. To start their second pathetic attempt at a power play, Brandon Montour ripped a juicy Lucy slap shot right into Jonathan Quick's blind spot to put the Panthers into a 3-2 lead, but then to everyone and their mom's surprise, the blind-ass referee made his whistle wetter than water by blowing on it and waved the goal due to goaltender interference. Panthers coach Paul Maurice wanted to show the size of his balls, so he challenged the play. After waiting for the guys in Toronto to get off the toilet and negotiate a buyout with the LA Kings GM and quote-unquote review the call, which by the way seemed like an eternity, the men with wet whistles finally said the call on the play stands.
Both trials reviewed, the call on the ice has been confirmed.
Yeah.
There was goaltender interference. Florida's assessed a bench minor penalty for delay of game. So
let's take a closer look at the mouthguard chewing Pillsbury Doughboy looking ass and his so-called interference with Jonathan Quick. I mean, come on, this league is a fucking joke. Anyone with half a brain could see he was out of the crease and he wasn't chewing his mouth guard that aggressively, and Mr. Jonathan was practicing embellishment like always. Since Matthew Tkachuk's parents never took anything away from him, his meltdown began to brew. It was time for him to take matters into his own hands and show Jonathan Quick how they did it on the streets of Calgary. Okay, let's rewind for a second. As you can see here, nothing looks out of the ordinary. This just looks like the Florida Panthers' attempt at coming back 6-on-5 with less than a minute in regulation, which was essentially how they had success all year last year, and Jonathan Quick laying on the floor, which is nothing new to us. But if you look closely, the rat named Matthew had a trick up his sleeve and did what any good sportsman would do: attempt to gouge his opponent's eye out. It appears that he made accidental contact with Quick's KN95 mask at first, trying to get the deflection, but then after the whistle blows, he shoves that little twig of his right into Johnny Boy's eyeball. The officials did not notice this melee attack move of his, but thanks to you snowflakes yelling at NHL on Twitter, they had a hearing with number 19 and handed him a 2-game suspension on a gold plate. What do you think of last night's soap opera? Is hockey getting too soft, or was justice served? Don't forget to subscribe for super high quality hockey videos, and I promise I will never use clickbait YouTube titles like the rest of the platform. Lord Stanley is out.